With negotiations underway, the National Pork Producers Council has repeated its request that a modernized North American free trade agreement maintain the zero tariff rate on pork traded in North America. President Trump has made updating the 23-year-old trade deal between the United States, Canada, and Mexico a priority since before taking office and even considered withdrawing from the agreement. The NPPC has been one of the leading agricultural voices in support of the agreement, issuing a white paper and twice testifying before congressional committees on the benefits of the pact. Since NAFTA went into effect on January 1st, 1994, U.S. trade north and south of the borders has more than tripled, growing more rapidly than U.S. trade with the rest of the world. Canada is the number two market for U.S. agricultural products. Mexico is number three. For more on this and other news from the center of the plate, please visit foodmarket.com. In other news, Southeast Alaska is reducing their Dungeness crab season this fall. Here's SeafoodNews.com staff writer Amanda Buckle with the details.
The Southeast Alaska Dungeness crab season has been reduced this year. The season usually closes at the end of November, but the Alaska Department of Fish and Game decided to end the season early after an analysis of legal size male soft-shell crabs caught earlier this summer. The reduced fall season, which will run from October 1st to October 31st, comes after the Alaska Department of Fish and Game cut the summer season short by 3 weeks. The projection indicates that total season harvest will not exceed 2.25 million pounds. It looks like it will fall near the lower end of the range at 1.5 million pounds.
Thanks, Amanda. Next up, poultry market reporter Terrence Wells has the latest analysis from the chicken market.
During Q1, small leg quarters advanced 5 cents per pound, while medium leg quarters advanced 6 cents per pound, and jumbo leg quarters moved higher by 7 cents. Broiler meat exports during January, February, and March combined for more than 1.7 billion pounds. In March alone, more than 600 million pounds of U.S. chicken were exported, the second highest monthly total since 2014, which was pre-AI. During Q2, small leg quarters exhibited similar strength, moving higher by another 5 cents. Medium and jumbo leg quarters each moved higher by 4 cents per pound during that same period. Broiler meat exports during April, May, and June came in a little lighter at just over 1.6 billion pounds. Interestingly, April and June's export volumes were the lowest and second lowest monthly totals year to date. Some industry participants are attributing the recent decrease in demand to the multi-year high values currently in place. Whatever the reason may be, clearly it's impacting the market. Just yesterday, frozen leg quarter values were adjusted lower for the first time since last November.
Thanks, Terrence. That concludes our show for today. Thanks for watching, and be sure to head over to the News tab in Comtel for a comprehensive look at the latest market and industry news.
Prospector Online is a must-have tool designed to help you explore and evaluate new business opportunities in the protein market. Customized searches based on a specific criteria that fits your needs. Call or email us today to learn how you can unlock the possibilities at prospector.earnerberry.com.